Hey there! You can use flashcards for this lesson to remember everything you're studying. Links are in the description. Also, support kids in need by donating to St. Jude. Link below. Thanks so much. Let's begin. Phishing attacks are often built upon a three-act foundation. 1. Pretext. The first act is the pretext, which is essentially a lie. It sets the stage for the entire attack. The attacker crafts a scenario to deceive you. 2. Actor. The second act introduces the actor, who is none other than the attacker themselves. Their objective is to gain access or extract valuable information from you. And 3. Story. The final act is the story. This is the fabricated narrative that the attacker uses to lure you into their trap. Here are some real-world examples of pretexts used in phishing attacks. Hello, sir. My name is Wendy, and I'm from Microsoft Windows. This is an urgent checkup call for your computer, as we have found several problems with it. Wendy is not a Microsoft representative, and the urgent checkup is a ruse to either gain access to your computer or trick you into paying for bogus services. This is an enforcement action executed by the US Treasury intending your serious attention. While the grammar may be off, the attacker pretends to be from the US Treasury to extract more money from you. Congratulations on your excellent payment history. You now qualify for 0% interest rates on all of your credit card accounts. This pretext entices you to fill out a financial application, unwittingly handing over your personal details to the attacker. Impersonation is a core skill in the attacker's toolkit. To succeed, they must convincingly play a role they are not. Here's how they do it. Choosing the right persona. Attackers often select an impersonation target based on reconnaissance they've done. They might know your name, the organization you work for, your help desk's location, and more. They may impersonate someone in a higher-ranking position to increase their influence. Technical jargon. To add credibility, attackers throw around technical terms to confuse and intimidate their target. Friendly demeanor. Attackers act friendly and may even mention local news or events to make you feel comfortable. Once the attacker has set the stage with impersonation, they move on to the art of elicitation, a psychological manipulation tactic to extract information. This is prevalent in voice phishing or vishing attacks, where attackers often use these methods. Making you comfortable. The attacker will try to put you at ease, making you more likely to share information. Open-ended questions. They use open-ended questions to get you talking and revealing more than you should. Faking empathy. Attackers may fake empathy to gain your trust and gather information more effectively. Your personal information is a treasure trove for attackers. Identity fraud is a global menace, and attackers know how to exploit your personal data. Credit card fraud. Attackers can open new credit card accounts in your name or make purchases with your existing credit card information. Bank account access. With your personal details, they can access your bank account and make unauthorized transfers. Loan and lease fraud. Attackers may open loans or leases in your name, affecting your financial stability. Government benefit and tax fraud. Your personal information can be used to fraudulently claim government benefits or tax refunds. Protecting your personal information is paramount. To avoid falling victim to phishing attacks, follow these key steps. Never share passwords. Legitimate organizations will never ask for your password. Do not provide it over the phone or email. Avoid giving out personal details. Refrain from providing personal information that is not typically required during legitimate support interactions. Verification is key. Always verify the identity of the person calling you. Hang up and call back directly to ensure you are speaking to a legitimate representative. If you handle sensitive information, make sure to incorporate robust verification processes to confirm the legitimacy of the caller. Phishing attacks are becoming increasingly sophisticated, but your vigilance can be your greatest defense. Be skeptical, be cautious, and never underestimate the power of verification. In the world of phishing, the more you know, the safer you'll be. Thanks for watching. Help children in need. Donate now to St. Jude. Link in the description. Together, we make a difference.